No, I think that's really confidential. I mean, there is no question about that liquid biopsy is really a new way to get information about the molecular alteration of tumor tissue. And I'm actually not surprised that the results are getting better and better and improving, because the technologies are actually improving, and particularly at the analysis of mutation at the DNA level, but also at circulating tumor cells. Well, I think there are probably several reasons for that. One is that every new biomarker has really some difficulties to get really into routine clinical diagnostics. And the second reason is, of course, we need more data on the clinical utility of these biomarkers. So I think, in particular, the question, how does the biomarker result change the treatment of a cancer patient? And I think the EGFR mutations are a good start in that direction, but we need more results that show us how the mutation analysis is changing the treatment of a cancer patient. Well, I think that probably the best thing is to do the easiest method for a clear clinical question. For example, the EGFR mutations were a good start. I mean, at the RNA level and CTC level, the androgen receptor variant 7 mRNA analysis will be important for PD-L1 directed therapy. The PD-L1 expression on the circulating tumor cells will be probably the easiest approach. So I guess that in clinical reality, whether ctDNA or CTC are used is actually determined by the target, whether it's a DNA, an RNA, or a protein, and then probably the most robust assay will be implemented into clinical practice. Yeah, the Cancer ID Network was established in 2015, and we have the goal to do actually a thorough technical validation of liquid biopsy tests, whether it's ctDNA, CTCs, or even exosome or circulating microRNA. We are completely open, but our focus is really on the CTCs and ctDNA first. Our experience is actually that is doable. We are 37 partners in Europe, and we have created some clusters of activity around CTCs or ctDNA or even the exosomes that consists of 4 to 5 partners that do some ring experiments with a particular technology. My experience is, first of all, it works. The companies are interested, the academic partners are interested to work together, because each of those partners needs robust assays, because without robust assays, there is never a clinical implementation of liquid biopsy. So I guess altogether within the first 2 years, I'm surprised how well the large network is really working and how well the different partners are highly motivated to develop and test these assays for liquid biopsies. Yeah, I think I would expect that we will have more companion diagnostic tests that actually drive the use of targeted therapy, for example, the androgen receptor V7 variant or the PD-L1 expression test. So I think that the liquid biopsy will actually follow and guide these exciting advances in the therapy of oncology patients.